Yo, Corey, this is JT
from
Hawthorn Heights.
How's it going, man?
Pretty good. No complaints.
Good deal. First of all, JT, I want to thank you for bringing this incredible tour back to Stir Cove in Council Bluffs for another year. Tell us about the idea, the initial idea for this tour, now that it's in year three, how it's evolved and what we can expect from the show.
Yeah, absolutely. One of our favorite things is really just playing outdoor in the summer. And we, you know, as we get a little bit older, we're kind of terrified that people are going to stop wanting to do that because they have cell phones and they have every other advantage of, staying inside in the air conditioning.
Mm-hmm.
But really, it's just about embracing the essence of summer and how we grew up and trying to find cool places that we love. You know, we've always been a fan of the city of Omaha. We've always been a fan of Council Bluffs. Surprisingly, we've played there more than people would think. You know, we did a massive Fall Out Boy show there years ago. We've done radio festivals there and stuff. So it's always been really cool to us. We love how the river runs through the entire thing. And, you know, one of our missions is really to just go places that have a lot of fans that are underserved.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like the big cities get everything, but we're not from a big city. We're from Dayton, Ohio. So, like, we identify with where you guys are from way more than we identify with some of the kind of mass market cities to get every show in the world. So we're there to, like, provide a laid-back vibe. That's our, like, number one thing, is we want all the fans and the families and everything like that that want to drop back into their emo era from high school. We want them to have, like, a nice, easy day of just seeing the bands that they grew up, that, you know, kind of help shape them as kids. And we're having so much fun doing it, you know. A lot of people asked us specifically, why did you choose Iowa?
Mm-hmm.
And we're like, dude, we're from Ohio.
Yeah.
We love Iowa. Yeah. Iowa is basically a backyard to us, you know. It's nothing but flat lands and cornfields and good people, you know. Why would you not choose it?
We really appreciate you coming back, Rue, for another year for this. Now, I kind of joked with you last year, because I talked to you last year ahead of the Iowa Is for Lovers Festival, and I kind of joked with you about how you guys don't, on your own festival that you guys invented and put together, you don't put yourselves in the headlining position. I remember last year you guys were kind of dead center in the schedule, but you guys have moved up this year. You're like second billing right behind Yellow Card. I have to ask once again, why don't you guys put yourself in that headlining position?
Well, for us, we want to try and get top-tier talent from our favorite bands.
Mm-hmm.
So we always, you know, reach for the stars. And if we can get a band like Jimmy Eat World or a band like Yellow Card, bands that have these storied careers that we were inspired by before we even became known as Hawthorn Heights, that's where our heart is always going to be, because we are still fans of music,
mm-hmm.
and we do still love to watch a big time show. So yeah, so that's kind of the main ethos is if we're helping provide a lineup that we think is awesome, and most of the time we don't include ourselves at the top of that lineup because we don't listen to Hawthorn Heights. So I want to see Jimmy Eat World there. I want to, you know, eventually see, I don't know, in my wildest dreams, Blink-182 there or something like that. I don't want to see Hawthorn Heights there, even if it means I get to play longer and stuff like that, you know?
Yeah.
But we'll do it if we need to, because whatever the fans tell us and whatever the people want, that's what we're trying to give them.
Yeah, and you will have, because I'm looking at your tour schedule for this summer, and you will have plenty of opportunity at other shows to play a longer set and sort of be in that headlining position, because I'm looking, you've got not only some dates for the Is for Lovers tour, but you're also doing a bunch of 20 Years of Tears tour dates, one of which is just right down the road from us in Kansas City on August the 16th. We have a lot of people here in Omaha and Council Bluffs that will travel down to Kansas City It's not that far of a drive. They'll travel down to Kansas City to see concerts. Tell us about the 20 years of Tears dates and how, and what you're doing with those and how those differ from what you're doing at Iowa Is for Lovers.
Yeah, absolutely. So the 20 years of Tears dates are more of kind of our headlining show celebrating 20 years of The Silence in Black and White, our first record. And we, what we did on that is we just tried to invite as many friends as we could, that we want to hang out with all summer, that we grew up playing shows with. We'll try and make it a nice, chill, easy anniversary, almost like a high school reunion. Mm-hmm. You know, you kind of get back together, you, sit on each other's tour buses, or we pop up some tents behind the, trailer and just kind of hang out and talk about, you know, I guess the glory days. And it's been so much fun. It really is, like, that's kind of our time to headline and play last and everything. And even though there are other bands on the show that have been headliners in their own right, this is kind of our time to play our album. And Is for Lovers is just a little bit different than that. And the cool thing is they both kind of work together and they both also kind of stand alone. But it's been so much fun. And we're going to places 20 years later that we've never been. Mm-hmm. And we're going to places that are some of our favorite places that we've ever played. So it's just been a lot of fun to listen to music all day, hang out, and watch the fans who have grown up with all this stuff. Some of them are like, you know, just now at a point in their life where they can kind of go to shows again and check back in on the music that they loved growing up, because you know, you get to a point in your life where your life takes over and you start maybe going to college or getting your career job or having kids, getting married, stuff like that, and all of your like entertainment time is like sucked out of you by your obligations. Now our fans are getting to the kind of the age in their life where they can really maybe start to spend a little bit of time on themselves again. And I think it's awesome to see, you know, you got people bringing their own kids, and we're seeing the second generation of emo at these shows now. Mm-hmm. And it just shows how strong this music scene is and how much all of these bands have made a connection with their fans that they're now playing shows to their kids. And it's just really fun. It's really special moments out here.
That's awesome. On the 20 Years of Tears, are you doing that first record front to back, or is it just sort of a heavy emphasis on that album?
Yeah, we do it front to back. We do it in sequence. We'll hold Ohio Is for Lovers till the end, obviously. Otherwise, there'll be a riot. So, because we don't want to have to play it twice.
Right.
Although that would be funny.
I don't think I honestly don't think anybody would mind. It would be kind of funny.
And some people are probably, you know, 8 white claws deep at that point. They might not hear it the first time.
Yeah, exactly.
But yeah, it's been a lot of fun, man. And it's celebrating that album that we didn't think much of at the time because we were just hanging on for dear life. And the way everybody has, like, embraced it and everything, it's just been a lot of fun and always just so surprising to us that anybody still cares. And I mean that in the best way possible.
Yeah, yeah. On the phone with JT from Hawthorn Heights, we're talking Iowa Is for Lovers, August 24th, Sturcove, Harris Casino. That's Yellow Card, Hawthorn Heights, State Champs, Armor for Sleep. Many more tickets available at Ticketmaster. And we're also mentioning the Kansas City date for 20 Years of Tears Tour, which is a bit of a different experience. That's August 16th at Uptown Theater. So you're very busy. You're keeping busy. What's over the horizon? What's next for Hawthorn Heights after this summer is over with?
Yeah, I mean we've been talking about when does the great nap kick in? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like when when do we get to go home and stay home? And you know, that's kind of one of our focuses for next year is being on the road a little bit less, mm-hmm. working on new music, working on different music of original songs and stuff like that, and really just digging back into the studio and trying to serve our fans that way. But, you know, we have some stuff that we're talking about and that we're working on, and we're not going to go crazy this year because we all want to prove 20 years in. So hard.
now we're going to be able to kill me.
We won't sleep forever. We like to take the winters off because we're from Ohio, and it's just gross and cold and. Give me the palm trees somewhere, even if it's me watching palm trees on TV.
Well, JT, thank you so much for taking the time for us today. Thanks for taking the time for us last year as well. I appreciate you talking to me 2 years in a row, and we appreciate you coming here for Iowa is for Lovers for yet another year at Sturcove Harris Casino, and we'll look forward to seeing you coming up here in just a few weeks.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much. You know, we're... hoping that it's as great as it was last year. I think it's a testament to how awesome the fans from the area that Sturcove is in. They just come out and they sing and they're loud. And, you know, this is just a wonderful Midwest culture that you guys have there. And we're looking forward to coming back and having a great time at Sturcove. And, you know, maybe we'll win a little bit, maybe we'll lose a little bit, but we're all going to have a great time.
Yeah, we are. We're going to have a blast, JT. We'll see you then. Thank you so much. Have a great rest of your day.
Awesome. Thanks a lot. You too.